But getting back to my childhood, let's see, what shall I talk about first of all? It's odd, but as I think of my childhood, I think of the good times and the bad times. The bad times, and mind you, 1926 is when I was born, so 1932, I was 6 years old. And what are my early memories there? Well, I remember 5 years later when I was 11, I remember my brother coming home one morning and saying that he couldn't play with his friend Jamie anymore because his mother told Jamie that, no, you can't play with a Jew boy. And so much before that even, I was experiencing the anti-Semitism of that time. At the time, there was a Catholic priest by the name of Father Coughlin, who every Sunday would broadcast an hour speech, which was broadcast over 435 radio stations, and all of it total anti-Semitism. So in the radio, as well as my life, I could experience that sort of thing. one of my memories along that line, I used to go to Hebrew school, and in order to get there the shortest way, I had to cross railway tracks. And I remember crossing these railway tracks. You were supposed to walk over a pedestrian bridge, but I took the shortcut, and it was already dark. And as I crossed the railway tracks, a man came up from the darkness and flashed his badge and asked me what I was. That meant, well, are you Irish or are you Jewish? And I said, well, I'm Jewish. And he said, well, you know, you're not supposed to cross these tracks. This is private property. And I'm not going to arrest you now, but sometime in the next week or two, I'll come to your home and meet your parents. Well, that scared me. Not enough so that I didn't continue to cross the tracks, but enough to remind me in an official way this time that anti-Semitism was going to be part of my life.